Apple released the visionOS SDK yesterday, so we can finally start building new apps or adopting our existing apps for the Vision Pro. Today's video is the first in my visionOS playlist, and we're gonna cover the fundamental building blocks that you need to know before you start building. At the core of visionOS are windows, volumes, and spaces. These are foundational to the platform. A window is essentially a spatial version of the window we're so used to on a Mac or an iPad. It's a fundamental view that your app will use. For example, this is a window. This is a window. This is a window. Now, windows can have 3D objects in them to get that nice mix of 2D and 3D, but as you can see, it's pretty familiar to what we're used to. Now, a volume is where you can have a 3D experience. It's kind of like this imaginary cube where you define the width, the height, and now you define the depth to determine how big the volume is. And here you can show things like, you know, the earth or a heart in an anatomy app. And volumes and windows can live in the same space so you can have them side by side. Now, volumes use UIKit or Unity to bring in that 3D experience. So again, window, pretty typical user interface that we're used to. If you want that 3D experience, that's when you gotta bring in a volume. Now, spaces are where your windows and volumes can live side by side. And there's two types of spaces. There's a full space where your app takes over the entire space, right? Only your app is active. You can have multiple windows, multiple volumes. You can adjust the immersion level where you have pass-through, where you can see the room around you, or you can have full immersion for your app-specific experience. In a full space, again, where your app takes over and your app is the only one that's active, that is where you can utilize ARKit features like skeletal hand tracking to, you know, play a hand game, or if you wanna throw a ball up against the wall, something like that, that is when you need a full space. Now, the other kind of space is a shared space. This is where you can have multiple apps open at once. You know, you may have a Safari window up next to the messages window. So again, multiple apps can live in the same space. That is a shared space versus a full space where your app takes over and you can be completely immersed in your experience. Now for the most popular question in iOS dev, SwiftUI or UIKit? Now visionOS itself, a lot of the system stuff is built on SwiftUI, and Apple's been very clear, SwiftUI is the future. The best way to build apps is with Swift and SwiftUI. Like, they're banging us over the head with, hey, use SwiftUI going forward. So of course, if you were building a brand new app for visionOS, yeah, SwiftUI is a no-brainer. Where it gets a little tricky is if you have an existing app that is built primarily in UIKit. And I can't answer this question for you. This is very personal to your project. You know, of course, on the extreme, if you have 3 million lines of code all in UIKit, yeah, converting that to SwiftUI is probably not very reasonable. So you can still write UIKit in visionOS. So you can write both. But I guess my advice to you, but again, what the hell do I know? This stuff just came out. If you do have a reasonable code base, I think this is a great opportunity to maybe start migrating over to SwiftUI to prepare yourself for the future of Apple. But again, every project's different. Do what's best for you. Speaking of those existing apps, how much work are you gonna have to do to bring it to visionOS? Well, if you're okay with a lesser experience, you're not gonna have to do anything, because there's a visionOS parentheses designed for iPad or designed for iPhone, where you'll get your iPad or iPhone experience right in visionOS, right out of the box. You don't have to do pretty much anything. But if you look at visionOS, this glassy look, you don't get that with just out of the box iPad. And I think in the beginning, because I do feel like Vision Pro is gonna take a little bit for, you know, for the adoption, it's expensive, people aren't used to it. So in the beginning, I think if you have this generic iPad experience, it's probably fine. But as time goes on, eventually, when everyone gets used to this glassy UI and more people have Vision Pro, it's gonna look really bad when your app isn't adapted to visionOS, right? It's gonna be like looking at an iPhone app on an iPad. It's just gonna be a bad experience. So yes, you don't have to do anything to get the typical iPad experience or iPhone experience, but if you do want this glassy UI and the new visionOS experience, that is going to take a little bit of extra work. Depending on your existing app, right? If you've built in SwiftUI and if you've used all of Apple's Swift components, you know, nothing custom out of the box, you're gonna get a lot of the work done for you. Yes, there are gonna be UI tweaks. There's gonna be certain tweaks in the app because not everything in iOS or macOS is supported in visionOS. So you're gonna have to do some work, but again, the more Apple components you use, the more SwiftUI you've used, the less work you're gonna have to do. Let's talk about Xcode, where you're gonna build your app for visionOS. Like I just mentioned, you can have this design for iPad checkbox, you don't have to do anything, or you can add a new target for visionOS and, you know, do it properly. Xcode also has a visionOS simulator, which is pretty cool, so you can see how your visionOS app will look in a Lightroom or a Darkroom or in various environments. There's a separate app called Reality Composer Pro that will help you build your 3D scenes with, you know, particles, spatial audio, so you can have audio coming from a certain object and going a certain direction. So Reality Composer Pro is where you're gonna build your 3D scenes. And you can also use Unity to build your 3D experiences and bring them in. Let's talk about designing your app for visionOS. Well, again, just yesterday, Apple dropped the new update to the Human Interface Guidelines, which has a whole section on visionOS and spatial computing in the completely new paradigm that we're, you know, moving into over the next few years. So definitely check that out. But some highlights is there's no such thing as dark mode and light mode. This glass user interface will automatically adapt based on the lighting in the room to provide the proper, you know, light mode or dark mode, for lack of a better word. VisionOS uses the same point system that we're all used to for laying out your UI, so there'll be some familiarity there. You will have to create a new app icon because app icons with this 3D effect are now built in layers. So you give Xcode the three layers and then it handles, you know, the shadow and the 3D blowout effect for you. So start thinking about your app icon design and how it can be broken down into layers. And when it comes to text, it is best to use the built-in text in SwiftUI, or it's also in UIKit, of the, you know, dot title, dot body. And that's because on visionOS, text will get a size bump and a weight bump just the way the UI looks. It seems a little farther away, so the text needs to be bigger and bolder. And again, if you're using dot title, dot body, dot footnote, all that stuff for your font sizes, you will get that bump for free. If you're hard coding your font sizes, like I am in Creative View right now, because adopting dynamic type is a huge project to adapt my UI to it, you can see here, look how tiny my text looked when I brought it over to visionOS. So yeah, use the built-in font sizes. And in general, if you're gonna have an app on visionOS and iPad and iPhone, try to use as many Apple system components as possible, because those are gonna translate seamlessly from platform. For example, tab bar. Tab bar is gonna look like this on an iPhone. And then a tab bar will look like this on visionOS without any work. In typical Apple fashion, visionOS takes privacy seriously. As you know, there's a lot of eye tracking and hand tracking going on, but your app doesn't know that by default. All your app gets is the events. So if I pick something with my eyes and then pinch my fingers together to select it, my app doesn't know that eye positioning. My app doesn't know the hand positioning. That's all private. Unless there's a very good reason your app needs that information, then you can pop up the permissions prompt, similar to asking for someone's location or asking access to the microphone or the camera. The typical permissions prompt, the user needs to actively give you permission to access that kind of stuff. So as expected, Apple does take the privacy seriously with Vision Pro. There's your introduction to the fundamentals of visionOS. Of course, we're just scratching the surface. We're just getting started. The SDK just came out yesterday. Stay tuned to the channel. There will be a ton more Vision Pro, visionOS videos over the coming weeks, months, years. We'll see you in the next one.